Hey, welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe. Lee, we're continuing. You're not quick enough.
That was good. Hey!
Languages.
Yes, and languages. And I have a favorite blogger that I want to show today because actually I've mentioned him on the show a couple times, Larry Ferlazzo. Mm-hmm. And he blogs about favorite websites. He does top 10, top 20. He is an English language
learner, had to look up some of those things.
We did. ESL, EFL, ELL. And it's all about, he teaches English language of other languages. English learners of other languages.
Yes.
Okay, there we go. So anyway, but what I wanted to say was, you know where I get all my information?
You go through Twitter, don't you?
I do. I allow people on my personal learning network to do my work for me. I'm stealing my paycheck.
And the other thing is that you've got a presentation coming up real soon online.
I do.
Where you're going to talk about your personal learning network.
Pumping up your personal learning network. That's actually April 24th. It's the Discovery Educator Spring Virtual Conference. So
you know what? Remind me. We need to put a link for that on PalmBreezeCafe.com.
That'd be great. That's a great free staff development day online. It's wonderful, and I'm looking forward to doing that. So I'm going to show people how to pump up their personal learning network. And one of the people that I have on my personal learning network and I'd like to recommend to you is Larry Ferlazzo. You can follow him on Twitter, and I have my Twitter stream open here. Well, actually, I have Larry's page open. And what you can see here is that he tweets links frequently. He's really not one of those people that tweets personal things like, you know, hey, having Cheerios for breakfast. But he is very approachable and personal. Anyway, you know, so there's times when I've tweeted something, I've needed advice. So yeah, he's a great wealth of resources. He's also very approachable and very helpful on a personal level. So he will respond to you. He will interact with you. He's really an awesome educator to follow on Twitter.
You don't have to join Twitter to go to the twitter.com/Larry Ferlazzo, do you?
That's true, because he does not protect his tweets.
Right, so you could go there.
You
don't even
have
to join Twitter. You could take advantage of this great resource.
Yep, I would do that, definitely. And, I'm all for joining and interacting as well. So, but anyway, so Larry Ferlazzo, he not only tweets about great things that he finds out there in the world as he does his, you know, goes about his day, and when he finds something, he shares it with his personal learning network. Look, he's following 870. He's got over 4,000 followers. So other people just like me and you who feel like he's really just a great value. But his blog is Larry Ferlazzo's Websites of the Day for teaching ELL, ESL, and EFL. And you know what? I don't teach these subjects, but I find myself coming back to his blog all the time.
He has so much stuff, and actually his blog was a little bit of a challenge for us to find, but we're going to put the URL for it up at the end of this segment, so make sure you pay attention
to that. It's larryferlazzo.edublogs.org. He has some other blogs. That's why it was a challenge. If you Google Larry Ferlazzo, you'll find these. But anyway, this is what it looks like. This is the one, the Websites of the Day. It's his website series. And he does a best of series. This is, I'm going to go ahead and click on home.
Yeah, so we can see how to get to this.
Right. So when you get to his blog through the root domain, larryferlazzo.edublogs.org, you'll see what he blogged today, April 8th. Okay, you can see the dates. He posts very, very often, which is really nice. But then he's got over here some links to his content, and he's got it organized really very simply and where it makes sense. Okay, so he's got a little bit of how to subscribe. So you know what? You can have his blogs coming to you by email.
That would be great.
That's really nice also. I do that with his, and I do it with also Free Tech for Teachers with Richard Burnside. So one of my other favorites that we've talked about here on Palm Breeze Cafe. He's got Websites of the Month. He's got Websites of the Year, Best of Series, Favorite Posts, Articles he's written, Awards he's received. But we're going to jump to the Best of Series.
Best of. So he's got a few sites in here. We looked at this earlier, and it's like, oh my God, he's got so much. Every subject area, he covers so much for the classroom.
Yep, absolutely. And you know, what I really like about it is that he has a lot, but he doesn't have too much. I've been on people's sites where they have their favorite websites categorized. So there's, you know, English sites and science sites and geography sites, but there's 50 to 75 websites. I could go to Google for that.
Yeah.
If I want so many resources, I can do the research myself. So, but what he's done is he's really done a great job of vetting these websites. And what he's done here is these are not links to websites yet. These are links to the best of. These are his blog posts where he's created the best of. Okay, so this is, say, his top 10 or top 15 or top 20. And so here he's got best art websites for English learning students. classroom practices when a good class goes bad, how about maintaining class discipline, what to do when you're having a bad day at school. Okay, I'll bet that'll get a lot of links.
And you've got to remember that the classroom
doesn't
stop.
We're counting down.
It doesn't stop at the school door. Parents should be looking at these resources. They're great.
Absolutely. Here we've got general ELL and ESL. Okay, he's got, we're going to come back to this, but he's got games. Okay, games is not just
learning
about.
Games.
Yeah, it's not just about sitting back and playing, you know, Donkey Kong. Okay, mm-hmm. There's a lot of great justification for gaming in the classroom. Health, holidays, anniversaries, and celebration, lots of science, reading. Okay, he's got lots of social studies sites. He's got lots of social studies. And again, I just said I don't like when there's too much, but he's got to categorize where it makes perfect sense. So I'm okay with this. Best what websites, best, easy for me to say, best web resources on Darfur, learning, best sites for learning about the presidential inauguration. I'm trying to get all this in. I know you're telling
you're
me we have only
3 minutes.
There's
too much.
Okay, so let me go back to the ELL sites. This is one, here's his best websites for English language learner students of 2009. So now you can see how it's organized. Again, we're on his blog. This is a blog post that he created. Mm-hmm. He posted it in November. And this is his list of best websites for these students, okay? Now, yes, they're for these students, but believe me, any student, any educator, parent, anybody would find these of great value. He's got here Grapevine, it's an audio chat board. He gives the instructional relevance for each of these websites, which is really, really nice. And he doesn't spend so much time on each one, which is nice. You know, he really just gives you a quick, easy definition, a very quick summary, his quick review with a link to it. And so that's all you need.
Yeah, that's it. And it's so easy to get into. And so much information is presented so quickly. This is great. It's well organized.
It is. And here's one that he put in. Shahi, it's a dictionary. It combines Flickr images, Google images, or Yahoo images with vocabulary. So he's recommending this for students who are learning English. But what student wouldn't benefit from this? Type in a word. I'm going to go ahead and type in house. And what it does is it searches Flickr and it finds all the words that are tagged with the word house.
Okay.
I mean, all the pictures that are tagged with the word house. And then it also gives you
different definitions. Wow.
Okay. And there's the noun definitions. Here's a verb. Okay.
House. Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then, of course, if you click on the picture, it will take you to the Flickr image itself. So if it has...
And you have other sites that you can access, too. Like, it's got tabs there for Google and Yahoo.
And Google and Yahoo. So if you want to go through other sites as well. So Yahoo, it looks like there's more housey type houses, you know, depending on... it's all user-generated content, so you're at the mercy of those people who upload these images and then tag them themselves.
Okay.
But this is really nice, and this is just one example that Larry provided for us in his top 10 or top 18 of... this particular blog post, okay? So anyway, I recommend that people check it out. He's
definitely
somebody you want to add to your personal learning network, and just you'll get lost in his website.
Oh, I plan on getting lost there.
Absolutely. And we'll be back with more.
Palm Breeze Cafe.
Don't go away.